Good morning, dear friends. I am happy to stand before you today to explain the term prepaid expense. Before that, I like to place a request before all of you. If you are watching my video for the first time, you may not be familiar with my pronunciation. So I request you to activate the CC icon on this video, then you will get the script of my presentation also. Then come to our topic. Today's topic is prepaid expense. If an expense stands paid in advance at the end of the accounting year, such an expense is called prepaid expense. The meaning of the term prepaid here means paid in advance. That means the payment is already done, but services are not utilized on the date of preparation of final accounts. Prepaid expense or expense paid in advance should be carried forward to the next year. In other words, prepaid expense should be deducted from the total expenses of the firm. It should be treated as an asset of the firm because the party to whom the payment has been made is the debtor of the firm to the extent of the advance payment. Let's consider the adjusting entry of prepaid expense. Here the two affected accounts are prepaid expense account and expense account. Prepaid expense account is an asset account. Rule of asset is increased debited, and therefore here prepaid expense account is to be debited. Similarly, prepaid expense should be deducted from the total expenses and it should be carried forward to the next year. When prepaid expense is deducted from the total expense will decrease. Rule of expense is decrease credited, and therefore expense account is to be credited. Therefore here the adjusting journal entry is prepaid expense account debtor to expense account. Prepaid expense will appear as an asset in the balance sheet asset side, and expenses after deducting prepaid expense will be shown at the debit side of the profit and loss account. I'm going to give you an example. Suppose insurance premium of the vehicle used by the firm is payable at the rate of Rs. 100 per month. Accounting year of the firm is 1st April to 31st March. Suppose the firm took insurance policy on 1st July 2023 and paid 12 months premium of Rs. 1200. Here the accounting year ends on 31st March 2024, and therefore the 3 months premium of Rs. 300 will remain prepaid. When insurance premium of Rs. 1200 for 12 months has been paid, the journal entry is insurance premium account debtor 1200 to cash account 1200. Therefore, in the debit side of the insurance premium account, it is written as to cash account 1200. Then see the adjusting entry. Adjusting entry for prepaid insurance premium of Rs. 300 is prepaid insurance premium account debtor 300 to insurance premium account 300. Therefore, on the credit side of the insurance premium account, it is written as by prepaid insurance premium account 300. Then the net insurance premium of the current year has been transferred to the profit and loss account, the 900. This net insurance premium 900 will appear on the debit side of the profit and loss account to insurance premium 900. Here Insurance premium 900 debited in the profit and loss account is arrived at. By deducting prepaid insurance premium 300 from the total insurance premium 1200. Then take the prepaid insurance premium account. Adjusting journal entry is prepaid insurance premium account debtor 300 to insurance premium account 300. Therefore, prepaid insurance premium account has been debited to insurance premium account 300. This prepaid insurance premium is an asset. Therefore, it will appear at the asset side of the balance sheet, prepaid insurance premium 300. Therefore, I like to give you the most important point. If prepaid expense is given in the problem as an adjustment or additional information, it should be taken at two places. One, the profit and loss account debit side, deduct from expense. Two, in the balance sheet asset side. Normally, prepaid expense will be given in the problem as an adjustment or additional information. But sometimes prepaid expense may be given in the trial balance. If it is given in the trial balance, it implies that an adjusting entry has already been passed. If an adjusting entry has already been passed, it gets automatically adjusted in the expense account. Therefore, it need not again be deducted from expense. Therefore, no further adjustment is required with expense account in the profit and loss account. Therefore, if prepaid expense is given in the trial balance, it should be taken only at one place, that is balance sheet asset side. This point is very, very important. Therefore, I like to repeat this point once again. Two cases are there. Case number one, if prepaid expense is given in the adjustment or as an additional information in the problem. Accounting treatment is, it should be considered at two places. One, it should be deducted from expenses at the debit side of the profit and loss account. Two, it will appear as an asset at the balance sheet asset side. Then case number two, if prepaid expense is given in the trial balance, then in that case it will appear only at one place, that is balance sheet asset side. I hope that all of you enjoyed this presentation. Please be kind enough to note down your comments in the comment box. Please be kind enough to subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching. Bye. See you again.